What's up, guys? This is Hal Hart back with another video. Today, I am tackling a question from a subscriber. This subscriber asked some amazing questions. And these questions, some of these questions I like to cover, but I just can't think of them all. So he sent me this question, Mr. Daniele Rinaldi. And let's go ahead and look at the question. Now, this is actually the secondary part of his question. He explained the question once, but he had to re-explain it. And this is his re-explanation of what he wanted to be looked at. So he says, I have a shapefile in which, or I'm filling in the blanks. He put in a shape, but a shapefile in which each single row is a mountain municipality. However, the territory of several municipalities is not continuous. There are parts of the municipality even outside of the core of the main territory. For this reason, I also need to label the external pieces. But compared to the central core, some are very small, and the name of the municipality is, in some cases, is quite long. The idea would be a rule that adapts the size of the label font to the polygon area, or otherwise a similar manual modification mechanism. Okay. So you've seen the question. Let's go ahead and tackle this idea, and I'm gonna show you how I would handle this question. So, gotta get my voice ready for all this talking I'm about to do. I don't know how long this video is gonna be, but I do know you're gonna learn something from it. So let's get into it. I've already brought in my Poly 1 here. Just to example layer, you know how we do it over here, QGIS basic, we keep it super basic. So we're gonna go ahead and add a polygon in here. So just add a polygon, a random polygon out here. And this will be our first piece of land, okay? So there's our piece of land there. If we go to the attribute table, we'll see that there is one record or one row created here. All right, so he's dealing with a shapefile that has polygons that have parts added to them, right? So how do you add a part in QGIS? Well, let me show you. In this toolbar here, the advanced digitizing toolbar, you can actually add parts to your polygons. And when I say add a part, this isn't a new feature being initialized. This is another part of an existing feature. All right, so here's our add part button here. We'll click that. Oh, I forgot. You have to actually select. You have to select what you're trying to add to. So this is our feature here we want to add to. And we're going to add some parts here. Add part. So I'll add one part here that's actually in contact with the main body, and then I'll add a part here out here that is disconnected. All right, so we have three different parts here, but let me deselect. And now if I click on the main body, guess what? Those parts are also enacted. Okay. All right, so the next thing, now that we have our main body and we have the parts added to it, if we go to the attribute table, we'll see that this is only still one single record, okay? Now, let's go ahead and add a label to these features or to this feature, okay? So we're going to create a new field called label. We'll change this to text string. We'll put in here the length of 10 and hit OK, because I don't think I'm gonna go longer than 10, and I'll just call this one home. Okay, so we're gonna call that home, and we're gonna add this label to our feature. So we'll go in here and add this label really quick. Make sure you're in your label tab, hit single labels, and in the value box here, drop down box, we only have label to choose from, and we'll hit apply. And so we have only one section that is labeled. One section. So how do we get this label to label all of these, all three of our little sections here? Well, let me show you that. So there is another feature of QGIS that allows you to take a single part feature, which is pretty much what we have here. Even though it's disconnected, it still sees this as a single feature, and we're going to create multiple parts from it. Okay, so there's two ways to get to this option, and we already have this selected, so we can go to edit, and we can go down to see, where is it, we can go to split feature or features into parts. Okay, so if we look in our attribute table, we just have one record, but after we click this button, we've highlighted what we want to split. This button right here is on my toolbar, right in the advanced digitizing toolbar here. We'll click this, click, and we'll get a little message that says that our feature has now been split into three singular features. So if we go to the attribute table for it, now we have three records created. Now let's go and relabel this. So we'll double click on our, and as you can see, when I double clicked off of it, we have three independent features that are all named the same. And now, can you see that? The home just popped in. Now, I didn't pause the video or anything. It just needed to update. I just need to click off of these and it just updated right there. So now all three of these are named home. Now let's tackle the other part of his question, which was the sizing of the labels. Okay, so let's go ahead and open up our layer here. And we have our single layer labels. You know what? I don't need this. Let's go and open up the attribute table, is what I meant to open up. And with the sizing of the labels, what he was looking at is he wants to be able to take the label and manipulate the size of the label with a dependency on the size of the actual polygon, right? So like, let's say this polygon is much bigger than this polygon. So I want this label to be bigger than the label out here. So let me show you how to do that. We're gonna create a new field because we're gonna need to get the actual size of these polygons out here, because without the size, this won't work. So let's go ahead and create a new, actually, I can bring it back down here and just make it wider. Let's create a new field, and this field we will call, let's call it perimeter, and we'll set this to decimal number real, length of 10, precision 3. We'll hit OK. We have our perimeter out here. Now we need to get our ruler out and we're going to measure this thing and get some perimeters. No, I'm kidding. There's actually a function to do this. So let's go ahead and download this function. We'll go up here to plugins, manage and install plugins. And in our manage and install plugins, in our search box, we're going to type calculate. And in this little drop down, we're going to make sure that we have calculate geometry installed. It's going to allow us to calculate the area, the length, in arbitrary units without typing expressions. So now that we have that installed, I will close this. And now, how do we use this? How do we get to this function? All you need to do is you come out here and, well, did I already? I added perimeter. Yeah, I did. Okay. Let's come out here and right-click this layer. Right-click this layer, and you will see a new selection here in this layer called Calculate Geometry. So we'll click this, and in this we get several options. The first option is the property. Do we want to do area? But I chose to do perimeter. If you choose to do area, you will be using squared units down here, right? Square meters, square kilometers, square feet, pretty much all squared units. If you use perimeter, you'll get simpler non-squared units. Okay, and also this is dependent on your CRS. My CRS is already set to the default CRS, so that's what I'll use here. But anyway, I'll do kilometers. Let me do kilometers for smaller numbers, or miles. Kilometers, I'll do kilometers. And another thing about calculate geometry is you have to choose the field that you want it to go into, which for me is perimeter. So you need perimeter here and perimeter here if you're gonna use perimeter. And of course, I name my field accordingly to what property that I was going to be using. The other thing, to get this to work, you need to highlight what you want to calculate on. So I need to go back out here. I need to exit this and make sure that I have these three highlighted. Actually, I'll just highlight one for now. I'll highlight this one. If you only highlight one and you run this function, so I go out here, go to calculate geometry, and I run this function, perimeter, meters, my kilometers, and I run this on that, and then I go to my attribute table here. Only one perimeter has been calculated. So only the one that was selected has been calculated. But we don't want that. We want all three of these to be calculated. So we'll select all three and we'll go to back to the function that we just did. So calculate geometry, area or perimeter, kilometers, and now we'll hit OK and go to our attribute table. And now all three have been calculated. Now this is a good place to take a breather. Give me 1 second. All right, let's continue. Now, the next part of this, we have the sizes of our particular polygons out here. Now, we want to determine the size of our labels. So we're gonna add another field here. Add a field that's called label size, I guess. Yeah, label size. And we're going to put in here decimal real numbers. It doesn't matter. Length, we're not going to go past 10. Precision is 3, so I just leave those defaults there. Press OK. Now we have a label size here, okay? And I want to determine the size of my labels with a expression. So first of all, in the drop down, I want to determine it for the label size. So I'll select label size, set it equal to a specific expression. So we're going to go ahead and get our expression out, expression builder out, function builder, whatever you want to call it. And let's go ahead and build a function for this. So those three, let me see, what were the numbers for that? 366, 262. Let's do an expression that selects anything lower than 400. So these labels here under 400 is what we want to select for first. So let's do case, what condition? Case when, let's do a condition with our fields and values. When perimeter, and we can just see some samples here. Here are our samples. When perimeter is greater than, or did I say less than? Less than 400. Okay, then what do we want to do? When perimeter is less than 400, then we want the font to be, let's say we want the font to be 20. Okay. Yeah, we can go with that, 20. Okay. Else, perimeter is greater than 400. Then we want it to be 40, the font to be 40. And then we'll just end that right there. Right there, just like that. Something is invalid. What is invalid here? Something went invalid. Case, what did I do? When, then the result, else, result, okay, else. I should just put else. Never mind. I put a whole nother else 40. Should be right, and then end. All right. So when perimeter is less than 400, then put in 20. Else it'll be 40. So we'll hit okay there on that equation. Okay. And out here, we don't see any changes yet because I haven't hit update. Update all. Now you can either update selected or update all, but since these three are all of them, I'll go ahead and hit update. And we'll see my font sizes change here. My font sizes go from 20, 20 to 40. Now we're going to revisit another topic that I've talked about before, which is data defined inputs. So let's go ahead and put these inputs, connect this data to these specific features. So let's go ahead and go out here to our poly, and in our single labels we'll make sure we're in the text right here, and for the font size we're going to data define this as the label size there. Data define that. And now we'll hit OK, and we'll see we have our 40 over here, and we have our I think I put 20 in there, 20 over here. Now at any point that you want to change this, you can just come out here to the edit button, and let's say if I wanted this to be 80 instead of 40, and then I wanted this to be 10 and this one to be 10. Okay. All right. Now we'll save that. And now we get our 80, our 10, and our 10. Okay. So I hope this solves the problem for you. I hope this makes sense. But if you have any questions or you have any kind of good ideas for new videos, please drop them in the comment section. I am working on them, but I also, since this year has started, I have gotten back to working outside of home a lot more, so I am away from my computer a lot more, and a lot of times when I do answer you guys, it is on my phone. So just let me know in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.